catching lightning in a bottle. Today, we're going to film a Get Ready With Me, so, bitch, get ready with me. Honestly, don't feel like actually getting ready. I don't really have much to get ready for, if I'm being honest. Don't want to do makeup, but we're gonna do something anyways. I'm just going over somebody's house for Super Bowl. Because it's
Super Bowl Sunday.
So, yeah. I don't know what we're gonna do. We've got soft glam. And brushes. So, why don't we, get something done? Honestly, I still have black under my eyes from mascara a few days ago, but I don't have any of my makeup remover with me. It's all packed away because we're still in the middle of moving, which, oh my, don't you just hate smudges on mirrors? Like, why, when people show their makeup, they have to hold it right by the mirror? Like, that's so unsatisfying, because I'm just thinking and looking at all the smudges on the mirror, and I made that mistake, so I have a little smudge in the corner, but, like, you know, I'm also kind of, like, tired of having really nice eyeshadow palettes and brushes that feel like cactus. Nobody wants to brush their eyelids with cactus hair. They want it to feel soft. Like, if we're buying a $40-something palette, which, you know, I guess isn't the worst, but if we're buying a $40-something palette, I better get a softer brush. You know, I had that problem with all the Naked palettes until the cherry one came out. That's their best, like, one with the brush. The brush is fluffier, it's softer, but, you know, I'm just sick of all these palettes having cactus brushes. Nobody wants that. Now that we're done with that rant for the day. You know, I think it's like around 2 or 3 in the afternoon. Who gets ready this late in the day? Apparently me. I don't know if anybody else does, but I think I have a caffeine headache. I've been drinking way too much Dunkin' Donuts iced coffee for the past couple days. Also, I've just kind of not been in school, and I've been chilling because, you know, switching schools, my mom took me out of school, and we're waiting for, I guess, the approval to get in, and it's taking a lot longer than expected, so, hope that's legal. No, I have too much stuff. That's one thing I realized when I was moving. I was just kind of like, you know I have stuff, but once I moved it all out of here, and this is, like, my second time doing a really big move, I'm like, dang, I really need to get rid of some stuff. Specifically clothes. I need to get rid of a lot of clothes. I have like 2 or 3 big garbage bags full of them and like other baskets full of clothes. I want to just take out like half my wardrobe and just start a complete new one. And just buy a whole bunch of new clothes. Anyways, I should probably start doing my actual makeup, which I don't want to do. Okay. Can I just slap a few colors on there, call it a day? I think that's what we're gonna do. I guess what's in Carrie's makeup bag. Tampons.
Tampons.
I finally got a paint pot, and I used it for the first time the other day. And I was kind of, I don't want to say disappointed, but I'm definitely not disappointed with it. I was just weirded out by how hard I had to dig into it to actually get product out. I don't even know if you can see it. But I thought it was going to be a lot easier to get on the brush, but you kind of have to dig in there. But oh well. Let's do some makeup. Oh, okay. Well, you know what? I guess once you get past the top layer, it's really not that hard. I guess I just got a bad paint pot.
Let's look like less of a hobo for the day.
I'm probably not gonna do full face makeup because, you know, that's not that kind of day. And, what am I doing? And, I don't have any of my moisturizers with me because they're all packed away. And I don't have any, yeah, no, shabada bing, shabada bing. This brush sparkles on it and I don't appreciate it because I'm just trying to get paint pot on here without sparkles and I thought I cleaned it. Struggle, struggle, struggle. I'm not the only one who like finds themselves using their finger a lot. Like, I don't know how some of these makeup professionals always use a brush and never their finger. Mm-mm. Sometimes you gotta take your hands and you gotta get in. I literally just cleaned up my eyebrows the other day, and looking at a mirror close up, my hair just, like, grows back in 2 seconds. I can't take it. Why do I always look so ratchet? I always look like a hobo. We're just gonna use Soft Glam palette that I recently got. Just because I don't feel like digging out all my other palettes. Checkmate. Oh, I should probably tell you what I'm doing, right? Well, I'm tempura. Tempura. Chicken. Kidding. I'm always hungry. I'm using the color tempura. I don't know if you can see it. I kind of can't see what I'm doing. Tempura. I think of chicken. Really do. Girl likes to eat. Just all over the lid to kind of set everything, you know. A blank canvas. You know what I'm trying. Why do I do this to myself? Alright, I guess I'm gonna take burnt orange to put all over my lid as well, because that's not a very dark color. Cactus brush coming in for the play.
Alright,
we got that color
slapped on there.
Now we're going to add another color. We'll go with
orange soda.
Or, yeah, we got it. We'll go in with the orange soda. I think that, wait, no, that's right here. Right here. Yep. Okay. I need to go back and get the Modern Renaissance palette. That was the first palette I was aiming for, but of course, they had it all sold out. And I wasn't walking out of the store with nothing in my hands. I'm one of those people. Okay. Slash. Now that that's ready. I mean, ready? What am I even talking about? How that part is done. We're going to add a more color. Oh my gosh. This color says Sultry. Let me flip it over. The color says... Anyways, this is a color that says Sultry, and I thought that said Slutty. I wouldn't be surprised. People have some crazy names for eyeshadow. What am I doing? Oh, okay. So, now I think I'm going to take Sienna. I'm going to take some Sienna and add to out here.
Crazy.
I feel like Jeffree Star should create a palette that's like dedicated to weed. like make it in the shape of a pot leaf and like name them all like Munchies and like Mary Jane. I feel like he would really succeed at that one. Like that would be the palette for him. Okay, now that we have a mess of eyelids, we're going to add the darker color. Knock knock, who's there? Aisha, that's who. Okay. Yeah, we're just gonna try to do that on the other side. I have a feeling this does not look like the other side. They should make eyeshadow palettes, like, if they're gonna have a long mirror, you should somehow make it so that half of it's, like, really up close and the other one's far away. So I like these two mirrors, because one of them's up close, one of them's far away. So, it helps. Oh, my foot's falling asleep. Alright. So, we're gonna slap. Go in with more paint pot, and just on the lid, I don't know if that's considered cutting thy crease, but it's considered something, and we're gonna do it. It's either I take too much on my brush, or I, like, take not enough. Never a good middle, am I right, or am I right? Then I'm gonna take this sparkly color called bronze. Oh, I just did that in mulberry on accident. Sparkly gold color called bronze. I don't know why it's called bronze and not gold, but you know.
We're gonna take another dip.
There. Ooh, I almost dropped this all over my palette. That would have been bad. I had a dream that I just got my new palette of, like, whatever, it might have been this one, and I dropped it, and it completely just ruined, and I was so upset. That is the worst. I remember one time, it was a wild night, and I went in my bathroom, had a little bathroom, and then when I went to the sink, I dropped an eyeshadow palette. It wasn't anything expensive, really, and just... Eyeshadow was just everywhere, smudged into all the tile. Oh, powdery brown eyeshadow was like literally everywhere. Oh. I have an eyelash on my nose, and I literally went to like blow at the mirror. Sleep
and coffee.
I think this is the eyeshadow look, and the eyeshadow look. Now, kind of don't want to do my eyebrows, but kind of might have to, because we already started with eyeshadow. Gotta have the flaky eyebrows to match. Now, I can't find my spoolie that I normally use, so I might have to use my other one, which is kind of disappointing, but... I guess I'll do a little bit, I don't know. Okay, I'm always so aggravated because this eyebrow is so different from my other one, and it never looks good. Well, sis, I guess we gotta do what we gotta do. Okay. Yeah. So, also recently just got the, dip brow stuff. Everybody says it's really good. I tried it once so far since I got it. As you can tell, it's only been dug into once, and you really don't have to dig into it that much, although it looks like I did just because I thought I would have had to. But this stuff stays on your eyebrows. Like, I leaned against my mom's shirt that night, and at first I was like, oh no, she's wearing a white shirt. But then I looked, didn't come off, and it literally, like, tried to wash my face, and it's very hard to come off. So your eyebrows are staying on, sis. we're going to try to not make these as dark as I did last time. My eyebrows don't need a lot because, you know, I don't really overpluck them, and I know if I were to just shave them off, I'd be a mess trying to draw my own eyebrows on completely. So I like to keep the shape there overall.
Carrie!
One second. We're back! Back to my messy eyebrows. Yes, chica. You know, I feel like they look a lot worse over camera than they do in person. I need eyebrow gel. You know, I kind of wish my eyebrows were blonde and that I could just... Technical difficulties. Yeah, anyways, I wish I had blonde eyebrows so that you can't really see my eyebrows, so when I draw them in, I can make them a really, really nice shape and, you know, barely have to do anything with them. But I bet people with blonde eyebrows wish they had darker eyebrows. Just like people with straight hair sometimes wish they had curly hair, you know how that all goes. There's a spot in this eyebrow where hair doesn't grow, but my little brother at one point threw a plastic Clifford dog toy at my eyebrow, and it, well, my face, and it happened to hit my eyebrow, and yeah, I think that's the eyebrow because it looks like there's a scar there and no hair is growing. So it all like grows weird and it like curves over that spot, and it's really annoying. Okay, that's all we're doing, because if I do any more, it's just gonna be way too much, and I'm not even going anywhere special. Just trying to look less like a hobo. I still need to find a different outfit. Mermaid hair, don't care. If the wind would not blow this everywhere, I'd probably keep it down a lot more. Long hair can sometimes...
be a pain in the butt.
I've been thinking about cutting it. But then sometimes I'm like, no, don't cut it. Oh, and like, look how... it looks like there's purple over here. Funny story. Yeah. When I usually would like dye my hair red myself, but I wouldn't use box dye or anything. Like, I would go to Sally's. So me and my friend decided to do it, and she wanted to try to do... black roots and, you know, the rest of red hair. Well, towards the end, we started running out of red hair dye, and the black, when we rinsed it out, did not stick in my roots. It blended in with the red, so it made a purple mess, and it wasn't even all of my hair. It looked so bad. It didn't look that bad, but I thought it looked worse than it was, I guess. People told me they actually kind of liked it, but no. So then my mom had to schedule a hair appointment for me and red, but it's all washed out at the ends, and I can't wait to get it redone. But here, like in Florida, when it gets really humid, my hair just gets so frizzy and gross, I just want to cut it, and it's so long and thick. You know, it looks like I haven't slept in ages, so I think we're gonna just use a little bit of concealer under my eyes. We're gonna use a little one of these brushes. Oh my god, I saw the blanket on my bed in the corner of this mirror, and I thought it was another face. Like, it looked like another me, and I got, like, concerned for a second. Imagine me haunting myself. Oh my gosh, I'd be so annoying. Okay. Both. Better than sex mascaras. Okay, I need to get different ones, because I'm starting to run out, and this, like, original one runs so easily. Like, so easily. And then, you know, I got this one. I really like how it looks like there's raindrops on the... wow, over here. Raindrops on the waterproof one. You know, sorry for the glare. Okay, so, and they... around Christmas time, I saw that they had this, like, whole limited edition, like, diamond, blah, blah, blah. And literally, it was only the packaging. It was more money just for sparkly packaging. Like, not... I wouldn't say sparkly, but it had gemstones on it. I mean, if I could see if the mascara itself was sparkly, then I would totally buy that. And honestly, this mascara was so overhyped at the time when I bought it and like heard of it. Yeah. But I continue to use it because, you know, I have it and I bought it. And the formula can get really clumpy. That's another downside of it. But, you know, if you're going to take pride in your packaging, at least have a really good product. I'm not saying it's... I mean, it's decent. It can be good, but it's not, like, really good. And it's false advertising. Like, better than sex? Honey, I don't know what you've been having, but... Okay. So, yeah. This is the basic beef look for the day, and I think... Have a wonderful day, and if you enjoyed the video, you should give it a thumbs up, and subscribe, you know, show your love.